to really be good in the beginning, if I said to you, what's the first thing you always have to do before you can change something? Your answer should be that you would have to select it. We must have a way of telling Word what we want to change. Now, there are different types of changes that you can make. There are character changes that change one letter, one word, or very specific parts at a time. And there are paragraph changes, which do have to affect the entire paragraph you are located in. So if you're making a paragraph change, you just have to have that paragraph active by having your cursor somewhere inside of it. Wouldn't hurt if you had the whole paragraph selected, but not necessary. If you're making a font or character change, you would need to select the words that you want to have with that. Let's talk about selecting because you should guess by now that it's going to become a very important part of working in Microsoft Word. And I think if you can make the easy things even easier, everything you do in this program is going to work faster, bigger, better for you. So let's take a look at how to select and different ways of doing that. And I'm just going to give you a few hints. Oh, there's so many, but let's get started with just a few. The first thing I'd like to do is take my mouse and move it out into this margin area on the left-hand side. Notice that as I move my mouse out here, it became a new shape, this arrow, which I think is a select shape. When you move your mouse close in, changes to that capital I, or anywhere within my document, it's the capital I. When your mouse changes shapes, it's telling you it's going to do something different when you click. So pay attention to the shape of your mouse. Very important. There's not a whole lot of mouse shapes, but if you learn those basic mouse shapes, it helps you with whatever it is you're doing in any Office program or any Windows application. So I'm going to go out here to the left again. I am pointing at any line that I have in my paragraph. One click selects one line, two clicks selects the whole paragraph, and three clicks, one, two, three, all the document. Even if it was a 10-page document, I would have all 10 pages selected. I'm going to do that again. One click, one line, two clicks, a paragraph, and three clicks, one, two, three, all the document. You can see that would make it quick and easy. So that is using the selection area out to the left of the paragraph. I'm going to do the same exact thing, but this time I'm moving my mouse into the paragraph. First, I'm clicking anywhere in the document to unselect. When I click once in a paragraph, it simply moves my cursor or insertion point around. When I double-click, it will select one word. Try it. Double-click on any word. Notice I might have something popping up. I'm going to ignore that for now. I'm going to ask you to also double-click on words. As you double-click, any word you double-click on, it selects. Now, I'd like you to be a little sloppy about this. What I often see people do is try to get at the very end of the word or the very beginning of the word. All that does is confuse the program. Don't make it wonder what you're pointing at or what you're clicking on. Go right to the middle of the word. Get right out there anywhere in the middle and do your double clicks. Don't try to be in a precise point at the beginning or the end of that word. That way, there's no guessing as to what you're pointing at or what you're double clicking on. Do you see how easy that is to just double click? Okay, let's try our triple click this time. I'm going to do one, two, three. Notice that instead of selecting all of the document, when I'm inside a paragraph, it does all of the paragraph. So a little bit different than my selection area out to the left, but still another quick and effective way of selecting things. Which is the right way to do it, do you think? Have you thought about it? Oh, doesn't matter. Which way do you like? If you're in your paragraph, maybe you want to do it there. If you're outside of your paragraph, maybe you want to do it there. Whatever's the quickest, easiest way to accomplish the task at a given time. Remember, there's always more than one way to do the same thing. Okay, let's step up your skills one more notch. Notice that as I selected a word by double-clicking in the middle of the word again, it selected that word, but when I moved on to another word, I lost the first word that I wanted. What about Can't you imagine there are instances where you want to make the same exact change to more than one thing at a time? Headings, for example. Maybe I have four different headings in my document, and I want to make the same exact change to all four headings. They will not be located right next to each other, so perhaps sometimes I need a way of selecting things when they're not located right next to each other. To do that, we are going to begin by selecting the first word that we want, and then using the keyboard. In the lower left-hand corner is the one I use. I press and hold Control in the lower left-hand corner of the keyboard after selecting the first word. And as you hold the Control key down, if you double-click on other words, again, right in the middle of those words, you will see that as you do that, the selection remains active on the previous items. And now, whatever I do would affect all those things that I have selected all at the same time. You can see how this could make you very efficient and effective at formatting and making changes to your document. I'm going to unselect now by simply clicking inside my document anywhere. Wherever I click, I know that's going to be where my active cursor is placed. All right, it's time to talk about that little pop-up that keeps popping up and making you crazy. So go ahead, select a word again, double-click in the middle, and as you move up and to the right, you will see a mini toolbar, is what this is called, appear. Remember earlier I said that in the Home tab, the ribbon contains the most common things that you'd want to be using? Well, within that, there's even some things that are more common than the entire ribbon. And what Microsoft has done is that when you select something, you're really indicating you want to make some kind of change to it. So when you select something, it will bring up the mini toolbar, which again took things from the Home tab, those absolute most common things located in that ribbon, and it provided you with a mini toolbar. Now you might not think that's such a cool thing when I'm in my Home tab, but this mini toolbar with these same options will appear no matter which tab or ribbon I am looking at. So if I am in a completely different area and I don't have those most common things in the ribbon at the top, simply by selecting the mini toolbar will appear. I can use the mini toolbar to make a change. I'm going to click on bold, and as I do that, notice that the bold button appears punched in. I'm going to call it in the mini toolbar in addition to the ribbon up above. So they are linked together, and it really doesn't matter which one you use to make that change. I'm going to undo using my quick access toolbar. All right, I'm going to do it again. I'm going to select something, move up and to the right, and when I do that, my mini toolbar appears. And what I would like to do now is not use the toolbar, and I feel like it's in my way. I don't want that toolbar there. You have a couple choices for getting rid of it. If you simply press Escape on your keyboard, it will disappear. If you move away from the toolbar in an area, it will also make it disappear. So either one of those are quick and easy ways to make that mini toolbar disappear. Later, as you work in the program more, you'll learn to appreciate that toolbar popping up for you. It makes it very convenient to access at any time the most often used commands that you may want when you're selecting something.